husker dere disse to herrene?
You're my heart, you're my soul. I keep it shining everywhere I go.
God kveld, Norge møtte Modern Talking i Paris. Det er 14 år siden låta You're My Heart, You're My Soul lå som nummer 1 på de fleste hitlister verden over. I sine glansdager solgte de 60 millioner album, men etter bare 3 år tok forholdet en brutal slutt. Mens i dag, 11 år etter, er de tilbake, og comebacket har gjort dem større enn noensinne. I Norge har de solgt over 90 000 album, og nærmer seg dobbelt platina.
Modern Talking were extremely popular in the 80s. So tell me a little about the history of Modern Talking.
In the 80s?
Yeah, when you first met, when you decided.
Yeah, you know, that was really easy, you know. I worked as a producer, and the record company called me one day and asked me if I want to have another artist. He was called Thomas Anders, and we did some records together. But first of all, we started in German language. And I was not quite satisfied with that, and I went in 84, I went to holidays to Mallorca, and you know, I came back and I was really in love, you know, with a girl, you know. And then, yeah, I wrote one night, I wrote the song Your My Heart, Your My Soul, and Thomas was just in that day in the studio, and I asked him, why don't you please try for me, you know, an English song, you know. Yeah, and he was singing then Your My Heart, Your My Soul, and I was really satisfied, and yeah, and then everything else is history, you know.
How many records did you sell back then?
Tons.
Yeah, 60 million.
Yeah, no more.
Oh, I cannot explain, every time it's the same. Oh, I feel very free, take my heart. I've been lonely too long, oh I can't be so strong. Take the chance for a man, take my heart. I need you so, there's no time I'll ever go. Sherry, sherry lady, going through emotion. Love is where you find it, listen to your heart. Sherry, sherry lady, living in devotion.
You had a lot of female fans back then.
No, you as well. No, you know what is really funny, because I have had a lot of friends in the Scandinavian states, and when we came to Spain and the southern part of Europe, he had a lot of fans, female fans or whatever. So because
where?
In Spain and you had in Portugal and it's because of his blonde hair. And because, you know, you're looking always for the opposite.
Do people still recognize you?
Yes, sure, they do.
Yeah.
You know, this is, you know, every day, this is part of your life. You're recognized nearly every minute. So,
you know, because our status in Germany is totally different, because I, you know, for example, I can only talk for me, you know, I was in the last 15 years really successful. I did 87 hits in a row in Germany. So that means I'm the most successful composer since ever in Germany. We are really popular in Germany. But in there are a lot of countries we are more popular. Like I think in Russia, for example, everybody knows us. You know.
Love is a burning fire, stay. Cause then the flames grow higher, babe. Don't let him steal your heart, it's easy. Girl, this game can't last forever. Why? We cannot live together. Try. Don't let him take your love from you. You're no good, can't you see, brother Louie, Louie, Louie? I'm in love, set to free. Oh, she's only looking to me. Only love breaks a heart, brother Louie, Louie, Louie. Only love's paradise, oh she's
Why did you split up?
We were always working, and then I was in that time I was 30, he was 20. That is a big difference, you know. And then I had always the goal and the aim, you know, I want to be, you know, successful in America, let's work. And he did, you know, let's have holidays, you know. And so, you know, if somebody, you know, you are only, you know, so strong as you both are, you know, and if somebody tells you, you know, I don't do this, I don't do that, you know, I was always, you know, a little bit disappointed, you know. My dream was always to have a number one, and then I had it, you know, and Thomas said, oh, easy, number one, you know. And I was like, come on, let's work. And he said,
second number one.
Huh?
Then we had the third number one.
Then the fourth, and the fifth.
And fifth.
Yeah, and then, you know, then it started, you know.
Yeah, but you know, I can't talk, I can't speak. I'm able to speak, not only him, so I just want to check this out. No, but you have to think about it. We did two albums in a year. That means...
Six and...
3 years, exactly. He also can count. So,
but only to six.
So, this was really a hard time for me, no doubt about this. So, you know, when you're 20, 21, 22, and you're just traveling all over the world, and you know, if you have the feeling you miss something in your life, and everybody's telling you from the record company or whatever, you are the biggest and you're on the top of the world and whatever. So all of a sudden you have the feeling, I really reached the top of the world. I have it. So I just wanna feel, I just wanna live the success I had. I will also say this is a matter of age, but he'll be back, and so we do it this time much better. And you know, now, with all my life experiences I have, I know exactly how, never ever take anything for granted. It isn't granted to be successful.
But the rumor was that your wife Nora was the reason for your split up.
Definitely she was a really hard a part of it, because she, on one, she had no clue about the business, you know, she didn't know she didn't know anything about it. For her, it was her character problem that she really would find out how far she could go. So she was always playing with the people, and because of the problem that the record people, you know, they were afraid to say no because it was a big success. They just want to, you know, split up the band for any reason. So she always said yes, we do this and we do that, and life, you know, sometimes one point came to the other. So in the end, it was really the best that we split up, and it, you know, I had my lessons about this and I had my experiences, but let's face it, it was not at that point not the right time, and if we wouldn't have split then, we wouldn't have had a comeback now, and you know, you never know why things happened.